What I would like to speak about is just, ties, as always, ties into Shannon's card reading. It's so funny. What I've been experiencing is right before the new year started, literally the night, last night of 2014, I just kind of had this big depression and really questioned everything that I was doing, the ways that I thought, who I was, all of this stuff. And it brought me to a place where it was just like, we can do all of this stuff, we can try really hard, but we need to be able to celebrate. We need to be able to get our solitude. And it's not trying to find that balance, because trying to get to a balance is acknowledging that an imbalance is possible. And when we are our divine aspect, when we embody divinity, we are not in duality. We are not good or bad. We are not balanced or unbalanced. We are who we are divine, and we are evolving at the most perfect rate that we are allowing ourselves to. So for me, it was just like really, not limiting myself. Being able to eat cooked food and being like, okay, that's not gonna digest perfectly, because I was stuck on this raw food thing, because I was, with me, I always try to do everything perfect, and it's always getting in my own way. And it was just like allowing myself to experience life without beating myself up and like, that's wrong, that's not the best. And one important thing that I learned since the new year started was, even if I think something is correct, even if someone is harming themselves, it's not my job to correct them. It's my job to do my best to help them learn what they need to learn, so they find the significance to change themselves if they feel the need to. I have my life. You have your life, they have their life. It's not our job to correct everyone. It's not our job to teach everyone. It's our job to feel awesome, share awesomeness, shine everywhere, and lead by example. And, just chill out. Life is serious, but it's also not serious. We can have fun all the time, even when we're not having fun. And it's, just, I find, myself included, but I find a lot of people, they just kind of get really stuck up in, ascension. I gotta do this, I gotta do that, I gotta do this. We can work hard, we can try our best while still being loose and free. We can, be very rigorous and use all of our willpower to advance everything that we're trying to, and we can do that without secluding ourselves to our own reality, to our own beliefs, to our own what we think is correct or incorrect. And for me, I found returning, well, rather, letting go of the person who I thought I was, letting go of the things that I thought to be correct. Allowed things that I used to do and used to think about years ago to just flood back in. And all of those things coming back from the past are allowing me to enter into that divinity, because in the past, when I was carefree and I didn't know as much as I knew now, I was able to, kind of be that innocence, because I was ignorant of a lot of things. And when I was doing things, quote unquote, incorrectly, I didn't know or feel the need to correct myself, because I was just learning. And that feeling of learning has come back with everything, and it's just like life is a whole new game, 2015. Nothing's going to be the same, everything's going to change, and everything is going to get better. It's inevitable. So we can let go into that, and we can create these families that are waiting for us, and we can just have a blast, create a bunch of things, evolve ourselves, and just really enjoy the celebration of experiencing life, this incredible thing that we are here doing. You know, we are non-physical beings in these physical bodies that aren't even like 90% open space, but I can still feel it. I can still, you know, I can't go through walls and stuff yet. But it's just like this experience that we are having, even if we sit in a room and do nothing ever, it's absolutely incredible just because of how it's orchestrated. You know, it's amazing. So dwelling upon incorrectness or, you know, this person's mean to me, this person, these people, humans, war, blah, blah, blah. If we dwell on these things as opposed to better ourselves so we can be more applicable in creating a reality that fixes those things or where it's already fixed, we have so much more capacity to just experience the joy of this incredible life that we are all sharing together. And it's just, it's so wonderful that we're all coming together since, you know, forever, but more so now and the end of 2014. And it's just, it's so amazing to share it with all you guys because we're all teaching each other and we all have our own strengths, we all have our own weaknesses. And when we come together, no one has any weaknesses because everyone has strengths that are someone else's weakness. And when you collaborate, you know, everyone is that strength.